to the excellent lecture, my experiences of Duperrier. Duperrier was one of those few scientists in my experience who had answered back to Blackie. Who was not, like me, salute, no way in doing exactly what he told me. But I had a debt of gratitude to this man. For a strange reason, I read his work on the geophysical aspects of copper phrase when I went up to Durham in 1956, and I was so impressed that I started some work on that sort of thing. See, the point about, I could go for a long time about muons, but the competition between energy loss, mass, pressure, and decay, UE decay, relates to Einstein's theory of relativity, the time dilation, and that then in turn to the realization that the pion decay was also important, and we use these ideas for spectra at a large angle. But more important than that, I realized that here was a subject where there was money to be had, and I was always still interested in money. And I managed to get a big grant from the American Air Force, Virginia,
yes,
who I convinced needed to know about the properties of cosmic rays in Durham and elsewhere, I'm sure, and the pressure curves and so on, because it has relevance to the defense of the United States of America. And they fell for this, and they produced money for a number of years.
They're not allowed to do that.
The same sort of thing with the American Navy. But finally, I must tell you about Perry. soon after moving to Durham, I organized in 56, I organized a conference, and he came and gave marvelous paper. But the paper was so marvelous that he wouldn't stop. And the chairman was Elliot, and he sat on the front row, and he would say, "Time is up." Perry would continue.
Time is up. Get it going. That hour would not continue.
So finally, in Durham, Elliot went up. Perry was still speaking. And he dragged him off the platform. It was marvelous.
It's had a way to finish.
Can I just say one final thing? I do hope